Today, I always look forward to this every single year. You know, I was trying to count today. I think it's the 221st anniversary of the adoption of the Polish Constitution, the second written constitution in the history of our planet Earth. The United States was the first, and patriots in Poland saw firsthand the importance of having a written constitution, and that's what we're celebrating today. We have the great parade coming up over the weekend, and we're going to be talking a little bit about that with the Grand Marshal. But I think it's important for the people of Illinois. Almost 13 million people live in our state. It's important that we join together with our fellow patriots in Poland and in Polonia, that we celebrate this very important date in world history. I had the honor of going to Poland back in, I think it was 2007. It was in 2007. Yes, we did. And it was just so inspiring to go to places like Krakow and Novosansk and to Warsaw. And as you may know, when I went to college at Georgetown University in Washington, D.C., one of my teachers, I had him for two courses, was Jan Karski, a great, great Polish patriot who, during the terrible days of World War II, penetrated the death camps and went to Churchill and later President Roosevelt to tell the truth. And I think it's so important that we celebrate our Polish heroes. Our state, I think, probably has more Polish Americans than any other place in the United States. And we celebrate the great heritage of the people of Poland. When I was in Poland, I saw firsthand the fight for liberty and freedom, not only back in 1791, but definitely after World War One, and then the terrible events of World War II, the Polish people never ever gave in to the Nazis or to the communists or to anyone else who would extinguish freedom. And that's what we're celebrating today. And so I want to bring forward someone who's very, very special to us, our Consul General, Zygmunt Matania. And Zygmunt, come forward and say a few words on behalf of the people of Poland. Thank you.
Governor Quinn, General Eniak, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I'm honored by your invitation to take part in this commemoration of the Polish Constitution of May 3rd, 1791. We celebrate the Constitution because it symbolizes the spiritual and moral renaissance of the Polish society after a long period of disorder. The authors of the Polish Constitution saw the government as a tool of service for the common good. They truly believed that the government must serve not in the interest of the few, but in the interest of the entire nation. The legacy of the Constitution of May 3rd enhanced the national spirit and helped the nation divided among the three partitioning powers to survive through 123-year-old period of enslavement. I would like to also stress that even for my generation, the spirit of the Constitution helped to keep our aspiration alive for an independent and free country during the Soviet oppression until 1989. Today is the fifth time I have the privilege to participate in this important event organized by the government. It is especially significant for me because it is the last one in which I am participating as a Consul General, as my term in Chicago slowly comes to the end. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you, Governor, from the bottom of my heart for your enduring support and collaboration which I experienced while representing Poland in Chicago. Last Saturday, despite your tight schedule, you found time to take part in event which celebrated Jan Karski. I, along with the Polish community, deeply appreciate your participation. Thank you, as well as for your recent letter regarding an upcoming visit of the President of Poland, Bronisław Komorowski. I am convinced that the visit will be successful for both sides. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to once again thank Governor Quinn for organizing this event. So very important for all Polish nationals as well as Americans with Polish roots. Governor, I salute you and hope that tomorrow you will be with us on Columbus Drive. Thank all of you for your attention. Thank you.
I really, really want to thank the Consul General for his just outstanding leadership. It's been a great partnership and friendship. It'll last a lifetime. And I think it is important that the parade tomorrow is a special day in Illinois, and we want to bring forward the Grand Marshal. Gracinia, we want to hear from you. Come on forward.
Governor Quinn, honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, I'm gratified and honored to be here today as the Grand Marshal of the Polish Constitution Day Parade. This parade has a special place in Polish community as it commemorates the Constitution of May 3rd, 1791, which was not only a milestone in the political and social history, but it also was an important European precedent, being Europe's first modern codified constitution. This very special day also celebrates Polish and all immigrants' contributions to our adopted homeland. The parade's significance was first made apparent to me in 1982 by a visiting Polish artist friend who at that time lived in exile in Paris. One day morning, as I woke him up, with words, "Get up, we are going to the parade." He looked at me with disbelief and said, "I finished the May 1st parades in communist Poland." I explained, "This is May 3rd parade." Reluctantly, he joined us, and then, seeing marches carrying flags and banners proclaiming the Polish desire for freedom, he wept for hours. He wanted to stay in Chicago for good. And to this day, only in America, we have participating in Chicago, we demonstrate our heritage, culture, political views, and our pride to be part of both countries. As we look to a proud moment in Polish past, we also as proudly mark our place in American society and history. To paraphrase Oscar Handlin, immigrants are American history. In my 22 years of work for Polish American Association and the 12 years as Director of Immigration Services, ESL teacher for City Colleges of Chicago, and radio art critic for WPLA, I have been serving and advocating on behalf of my community, explaining the need for immigrant programs, for immigration reform, and for visa waiver for Poland. I am proudly immigrant, proud to have my heritage rooted in Poland, but as proud to lend my skills and talents to my adopted, beloved country, America. Chwała Konstytucji 3 Maja. Niech żyje Polonia. Long live Polonia.
Just beautiful remarks. I want to thank Rosina for her great, great help of people coming to Illinois and to America. We want to welcome our immigrants. We want to be a welcoming society. It's so important. Just the, whether it's the language or the customs, it's so important that we have movements that help people. And we have our New American Initiative of our state of Illinois to help our immigrants. And I want to thank Rosina and all the people who have worked together with us on that. We also have a great partnership, the state of Illinois does, with the Polish military. Since 1995, I believe it is, we have had the Partnership for Peace, where our Illinois National Guard works hand in hand with the people and military in Poland. And I was in Afghanistan in 2009 in Ghazni province, which is patrolled by the Polish military, and our Illinois National Guard were with them at that time. And I was so impressed to see everyone there. I got off the helicopter in those mountains of Afghanistan, and the first person I saw, Rich Piotrowski of the Illinois National Guard, he went to the same high school I did. My brother taught him, and he was on the basketball team as well. So it's a small world, but when you get together with the Polish Americans, you'll find good people everywhere. And I think it's so important that we bring forward now our Adjutant General of the Illinois National Guard. He has some remarks regarding our commitment and our partnership, and that's General Enart. And General, come on forward and speak if you will. Okay.
Captain, please join ranks with my soldiers.
All right, Bogdan, good to see you.
I ask Bogdan to please step forward and join ranks with my soldiers as symbolic of the partnership that the Illinois National Guard has with the Republic of Poland and with the Polish military. This year we'll celebrate the 20th anniversary of the State Partnership Program. Illinois' partnership with the Republic of Poland is the second oldest, and it is today the largest state partnership program. We, the Illinois National Guard, through our interactions with the Polish military, provide 46% of the foreign military partnerships for the European command. This Wednesday, I was in Bloomington, Illinois, and welcomed home 17 Illinois National Guard soldiers who had just returned from Ghazni province. They had been embedded on the Polish staff of the Polish battle group. We already have another 17 Illinois National Guard soldiers serving today in Ghazni province with the Polish battle group, Brothers in War and Brothers in Peace. Standing right here to my left, Colonel Lawson will be the next commander of the Illinois National Guard detachment serving with the Poles. He'll be leaving, they'll be departing for Ghazni province with the Polish battle group in January of next year. This is a program that I tell my staff, I tell all of my soldiers and my airmen, this is the most important strategic thing that the Illinois National Guard does. As a military officer, I must be a student of history. When we look at history, we understand that when there is peace and freedom in Poland, there is peace and freedom in Europe. When there is peace and freedom in Europe, the world is stable. So we must continue to develop that partnership. We must continue to serve together, because together we are strong, and together we serve our nations and we serve world peace. Today I would also like to take a moment, and I would ask that the Consul General please step forward. As the Adjutant General of the Illinois National Guard, it is my duty to confer medals upon soldiers and occasionally upon civilians who earn them through their merit and through their good works. Consul General Matania has indeed earned a medal. Colonel Lawson, if you will.
The Illinois Military Medal of Merit has been awarded to Consul General Tigman Matania for exceptional meritorious service to the state of Illinois and the Illinois National Guard while serving as a Consulate General of the Republic of Poland in Chicago. His commitment to excellence and dedication to the State Partnership Program reflects great credit upon himself, the Polish Consulate in Chicago, and the Republic of Poland. Signed this day, William Enyard, the Adjutant General, Illinois National Guard.
Thank you. very fine. I do want to acknowledge our Alderman Ariel Robles, who's with us here today. I want to thank you, Ariel, for your commitment to bringing people together, and that's so important. I would be remiss if I did not bring forward someone who knows firsthand how important sacrifice is. There are no words in the English language or the Polish language or any language to relieve the pain of a mother who's seen her son from the day he was born, who gave his life for our country. And we had a great, great Polish hero, Jacob Kowalik, who gave his life as a United States Marine for us in Iraq. I went to Jacob's wake. I've known his mom for many, many years now. We did go to Poland together. We went to Jacob's hometown, where he grew up and where he went to school. And so I want to have Danuta come forward. Danuta, why don't you say a few words? This is a special day, and why the Polish Constitution Day is so important. Okay?
Yeah, I'm just honored, and it's a pleasure to be here, like always. And I'm very thankful for everything you did to us, like at Angola, especially for giving our families. And I am thrilled, I am honored, and humbled.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're the best, Danuta. Thank you so much for everything. Well, this is a celebration. We do believe in freedom. We believe in written constitutions. The Polish people, the American people, we're together now and forever. Well, let's get that visa waiver done. We got work to do.